Feeling like taking a coffee break? So do I. What about we talk about JEP 269, about convenience factory methods for collections, delivered in JDK 9 in 2017. Wait, this is a super old JEP. I know that, delivered in JDK 9. But it turns out that there are several elements that have been recently added, like list.copyOff or map.copyOff in JDK 10. And I would like also to cover stream.toList added in JDK 16. There are new ways of creating immutable lists in JDK, and I would like to visit them all in this JEP cafe. What did this JEP want to address in JDK? In a nutshell, the building of non-empty collections and maps. In the old days of Java SE 8 and before, creating a list with elements in it looked like this. And if you needed to make it immutable, you needed one more line of code with this call to one of the unmodifiable list or like method from the collections factory class. And this way was not very efficient, because calling this unmodifiable list method would always create a new list, even if the list you passed in the first place was already unmodifiable. And it was the same thing for the sets or for the maps. Thanks to this JEP, you can write much simpler code. List of, and you pass the arguments 1, 2, 3, and you're done. But it comes with certain constraints. First, the list you get is immutable. If you really need a mutable list, you can pass it to the construction of a plain old ArrayList, for instance. But maybe you can think again about having mutable list. Second, the list you get does not allow for null values. It may be a constraint to you, but knowing that your list cannot hold null values usually makes your code safer. Who likes null pointer exceptions? Usually, your IDE will warn you if it is able to detect that you're adding a null value to such a list. Third point, you get an optimized implementation. For instance, if you're calling list.off with no arguments, that is, you are creating an empty immutable list, you do not have element in that list, what you get is in fact a singleton. There is only one instance of this empty immutable list in all your application. And fourth and last point, this implementation is serializable. And the same goes for set.off. With this factory method, you can quickly and cleanly create a set of objects that is immutable with no null values. Now, you know that a set cannot have duplicate values. So because of that, writing the following code in which you have the same argument more than once will give you an illegal argument exception when it is executed. It may sound weird, but why would you write such a code? That second element will not be added anyway, so it's probably a typo in the first place, some bug that you didn't see. So yes, throwing this exception is probably a good choice. Map.off works a little differently. First, you have a map.off that takes a key and a value. Two words of warning. First, no null key and no null values in such a map. If you try that, you will get a null pointer exception. Once again, your IDE may warn you if you try to do that. And second, no duplicate key. If you do, you will get an illegal argument exception. You've been warned. As previously, the map is immutable and serializable. Now, let us think about the signature of this method, map.off key and value. It takes a key as a first parameter and a value as a second parameter. That is, two objects of different types. So the signature looks like this one. Expanding this method for several keys value pairs has to go like that. It turns out that these factory methods, list.off, set.off, map.off, go up all the way to 10 elements or 10 key value pairs. Past this limit, what you call is the off method that takes a parameter declared as being a varag. What could be the equivalent for map.off? Unfortunately, you cannot define a varag in that case. So the choice has been made to do the following. First, create an entry object with a factory method from the map interface. And second, use the map.offEntries factory method that may take a varag of entries. It gives you the following pattern that you can use to create a pre-filled maps with more than 10 key value pairs. You can even add static imports to make it even more readable and even cleaner. So far, we have factory methods that create immutable collections and maps that do not accept null values. There is another way to create a list, which is the arrays.asList pattern. This is a very old pattern from the early days of the JDK. Maybe you think that this list is immutable. Not quite. The right image is to see this list as a wrapper on an array. Once you have created an array, you cannot add or remove elements from it. The size is fixed, one for all, and cannot be changed. But you can change the existing elements of an arrays.asList. So, in this example, the following code will throw an unsupported operation exception. You cannot add, you cannot remove. But this one will convert the content of the list to uppercase, thus updating each element. And you can put null values in this list, even if it's probably not a great idea. There are two more methods I would like to talk about. The first one is the list.copyOff factory method added in the JDK 10. This method returns a copy of the list you give as an argument, which is expected. Three things about this list. First, the list you get, the copy you get, is immutable. Second, it does not accept null values. So you need to be careful. Filtering out null values before copying your list may be a good precaution, especially if it is a list that accepts null values. And in fact, it's just a single line of code, so just use it. And third point, it is a serializable version of a list. And then you get a bonus. If you pass a list that has been created with one of the factory methods that produces an immutable list, then there is no need to physically copy it in memory. So that list is returned directly. That's an optimization you didn't have with collections.unmodifiableList. The last method for today is the stream.toList method that was added in the JDK 16. What it does is that it puts the elements processed by the stream in a list, and that's it. You may be thinking that it is just a shortcut for the collect method that takes a collectors.toList collector as an argument, which is kind of true. But in fact, it does a little more. First, toList produces an immutable list, where collectors.toList produces a good old array list. Even if it's not in the spec, this is how it works. Second, well, I hope you're wondering, does it allow null values? Because all the immutable lists that we saw so far do not accept null values. Well, the answer is it does. So as long as you are comfortable with having an immutable list, you can safely replace your collectors.toList by a plain toList call. And in certain cases, you may have better performances. You know, when you add elements to an array list, at some point the internal array may become full, and in that case, the implementation of the array list will copy this array in a bigger array to accept the new elements. Of course, this comes with a cost, with an overhead. And it's a pity because sometimes you know how many elements you are going to put in this array. This is the case if the stream you put in this list has the sized property. Well, the good news is that the toList method reads this sized property and will create an array of the right size if it can. So no more overhead in that case. So yes, the performances of toList may be better than the collectors.toList. Okay, let us make a quick wrap-up of what you saw. First, we have plain array lists, mutable lists that accept null values. Second, we have the arrays.asList pattern. You can't add or remove elements, but you can modify the existing one, and it accepts null values. List.off, set.off produce immutable lists or sets that do not accept null values. List.copyOff produces an immutable list that does not accept null values and that does not copy immutable lists produced with list.off and set.off. And the last one is stream.toList that produces an immutable list that does accept null values so that you can safely replace your previous calls to collect collectors.toList with toList, as long as you're comfortable with getting an immutable list. And with this, I'm out of coffee, so that's it for today. Talk to you soon.